teachers, especially our volunteer parents, the Powwow Players Booster Club, which I like to call our drama mamas and drama papas, for always taking care of us. All those little things that I don't think about, that I'm here directing, they take care of that other stuff. So thank you, parents, for always being here for us. Off your cell phone or put them on airplane mode. We have about 14 wireless mics going at any given time. And sometimes if you don't want to turn off your cell phones, it might interfere with the frequency every now and then. So if you could do that, just playing safe throughout. And I know that first night was really funny. We were here the first night after I said it, an Amber Alert went off. All of a sudden it was like, and I was like, but the mics are messing up a little bit. If there are any small children that strongly disagree with the artistic vision that we have envisioned here, if you could please escort them to the foyer or outside or the parking lot or anything easy, that would be great so it doesn't disturb our patrons or the actors on stage. And no flash photography or videoing of any kind is strictly prohibited. We do have a designated video going, but that is for DSM archive purposes. We already have permission for. We have a great event coming up in about a week, ladies and gentlemen. This band right here, the best band in the state of Texas. We're going on a big event, the Jazz Cafe, February 4th at the Waxahachie Civic Center. Night of fun, food, jazz music, dancing. It's a great date night, guys. Girls, give a little elbow to your guys. I take you to that. If you want to know more about it, just go to the Waxahachie Band website. Just Google Waxahachie Band, and we'll take you right to it. And find out how to get tickets for that. It's great. Our own alumni, McKenna Armstrong, will be singing, and our very own good friend, Mr. Tracy George, right over there, will be singing.
side.
Why can't you shut that other bullet in half?
No, not quite yet.
Why can't you shut that other bullet in half?
The squaw is ready.
It's wrong line.
I wonder what bit belongs to the lips I long to eat.
This face.
Why, here's Alan Moldell, that friendly mailman from the east I was so crazy about. I thought you were all done with us.
Not when I finally found myself a home. Where I belong, keeping company with the people I care most about.
You came to us a stranger, rid this place of crime, and gave us new hope in ourselves. That's gonna be one tough act to follow.
Well, how's this? Will you be my lawful wedded wife, Miss Nancy?
Oh, yes, I will!
Make jerk enough, hard up for work enough to want a job like that.
fainted.
She fainted during the bows, when the critics dash out of the theater to dash off the postmortems. Face it, we have our notices and we've been given notice.
I'm afraid she's right.
No! You two are just sensitive because you roached the show. This is only round one. The first musical my husband and I produced was savaged out of town, but we rolled up our sleeves, did a major rewrite, and brought it all the way to Broadway. And that musical, my friends, was Kiss Me! I'm Irish. That was just before the audience opened their playbills, but the point is, this is a Sydney and Carmen Bernstein production. We decided the ghost to New York, not Daryl Grady of the Boston Globe.
So we're still shooting for Broadway?
Georgia Harris, you keep writing tunes that bounce. Oscar, you keep writing checks that don't.
That's very nice, but until our leading lady gets out of hospital, who knows what happens next?
They just have her under observation. I'm sure she'll be out by morning.
Is there no limit?
Sounds like our director.
Is there no limit?
She got that right.
Opening night, went for a walk past the Cathedral of the Holy Cross, winked him wildly spiritual. I mean, those Catholics, they know how to put on a show. Right down the middle of the Eucharist, I had an epiphany. At this stage in the life of any musical, one should refrain from admitting anything brilliant, but simply remove all that is god-awful. What, I ask you, without fear or contradiction, was the most god-awful thing in our show?
Jessica!
Of course, I came back here to convince you to get rid of our star, only to have the cast inform me that she's in the hospital. I see the hand of the law in this.
Mr. Christie, there's a phone call from you in your office.
Thank you, Jenny. That's probably my husband calling.
Well, where was Sydney tonight, Carmen?
Sydney's in New York booking a theater for us. And, knowing my husband, also booking a soprano who doesn't dance, but knows how to move.
At least she can joke about it.
Oh, well, it's easy to joke about marriage when men like you and Sydney don't take it seriously.
There is no comparison. I would be more than flirt with any woman in this cast once you and I got married.
Barbara O'Brien?
She was an usher. And besides, only after you moved out.
Oh, so you finally lived up from your music and noticed I was gone.
Jenny! You're the stage manager. How's the cast taking the reviews?
Well, they decided to dress the nine for a combination opening and closing night party.
Oh, defeatist the lot of you! You've yet to hear my plan of action. But hear it ye shall. Jenny, come help me walk you move this piano.
What plan? You think he wants us to go to Broadway using an understudy?
Well, at least we'd still have Bobby in the title role.
Oh, and that's what matters, right? I mean, the whole reason you teamed up with me again is to rekindle our romance, your leading man.
Aaron, when I signed up, I had no idea Bobby was in the show.
Oh, really? And why, on our very first verse, did you walk up to him and say,
"Hi, Bobby."
Hiya, sweetie. Well, it looks like we're all going to be heading back to New York a little bit sooner than we thought. But if you and I go back together, then this is one flop that's a big hit with me.
Oh, all be a misinformed. A brief demonstration of what's been wrong with his show since his very first love song.
You mean Thinking of Him? That's one of my best songs.
One of our best songs.
See, Georgia agrees with me.
Nonetheless, I've had a problem with it since our very first day of rehearsal. Georgia, sing our leading lady's opening number.
Which song is this? The new one with the lyric Georgia wrote about me.
Not Rockwood.
Oh, precisely, Aaron, play Georgia, sing. Jenny, put on my Q5!
Let's Q5? Well, this is silly. I haven't sung on the stage in years.
Oh, just sing.
Thinking of him. Thinking of him. Sometimes it seems I spend every moment my waking day. Thank you.
rehearsal. There is something wrong with this tune since the very first rehearsal. You'll have to tell me what.
Except we ever let Jessica Cranshaw to sing it. Listen, people, I know it's a damn shame that the leading lady collapsed on tonight's performance. She could have done it weeks ago. But the cavity that Jessica has created must be appropriately filled.
May I speak? As Jessica's understudy, I feel terrible taking over under these circumstances.
Oh, no need to feel terrible, Nikki.
Oh, but...
Oh, no need. Because you're still the understudy for Georgia!
That's why I didn't ever
have. I don't know, Chris.
Oh, you know the score of the script better than anyone else. You sing the words from your heart, because that's where they came from. I know it's been a long time since you traded in your tap shoes for
Excuse
a ride.
Excuse me! But speaking for those of us in the chorus, I really think Nikki should get the role. She's talented and dedicated and...
And since you're Nikki's understudy, she gets the lead, then you get her part.
Well, yes, that too.
Well, nice try, Bambi, but either Georgia's in or I am out. What do you have to say, Oscar?
Chris, I'll put my money where your mouth is.
Well, laundry first. Aaron, I assume this meets more with your approval.
To be honest, it doesn't.
Oh, well, thanks for the vote of confidence.
I have my reasons.
You always have.
And besides, the debate is pointless if Jessica shows up tomorrow morning.
God help us. Her performance this evening was worse than ever.
Jessica Cranshaw will never be better than she was this evening.
But she was horrible.
I know. But she'll never be better. She's dead! That's with the hospital on the phone. In terms of future performances, Jessica Cranshaw now has a conflict.
Well, what happened?
Tell me.
Chris, do you want to say something to the company about Jessica?
Shall we observe a minute of silence? To match the audience's response to Jessica's first number. Oh, all right. Let's all form a semicircle. I'll go over there. I'll go there. Bambi! You're blocking the whole left side of the stage! Jessica was part of our company, and now we part company. I'm sure we'll all remember her in our thoughts and our resumes. And as lesbians, I know you'd like to display your sorrow as both a tribute and an acting exercise. Jeremiah F sharp minor.
Plans, the woman's dead.
With someone came to see.
let my work delay your production from reaching the home on Broadway it genuinely deserves. I happened to see Robert Hood in the previews, and, well, let me just say that with the exception of the deceased Miss Crenshaw, you're all such wonderful performers. And what a great score.
Well, I appreciate that, Lieutenant.
On behalf of my half, that compliment to Davis as well.
Well, you're very welcome. In fact, I happen to do a little community theater myself. Well, no, nothing that fancy. Although, my Billy Bigelow of the Brooklyn Bond House did receive a favorable review.
Oh.
In A Midsummer Night's Dream, my bottom was very well received.
Wait a minute. You say you're from Homicide?
Well, yes. Based on a preliminary autopsy, it's clear that Jessica Crenshaw was murdered.
And what are we to do with her killer? Does he get some type of trophy?
Chris!
Oh, sorry, pure reflex.
What killed her?
Hydrocyanic acid. It's commonly used in electroplating in the gas chambers at San Quentin. It was in capsule form, which is why nobody noticed that she'd been poisoned until after the capsule was dissolved in her stomach, creating her own personal gas chamber, internally.
That's horrible.
But looking backwards, when the capsule dissolved, we know that she died in the final moments of this evening's performance.
Well, couldn't she have poisoned herself?
Trauma at the back of the throat suggests she did not take the capsule voluntarily. Now, may I ask you to touch it other than myself?
Oh, permit me, Lieutenant. I am critically acclaimed director, Christopher Belly, and I will be blocking your investigation.
Well, I certainly hope that's not the case, Mr. Belly, but if you need to wrap things up with your cash, go right ahead.
Company, I'm sure you will give Georgia your full support as she steps into late Miss Crenshaw's shoes.
My God, that's brilliant!
As one of what expected from me. All those willing to press forward with Robin Wood and Georgia, give me a show of hands.
That's it? Listen, people! Life is full of setbacks and disappointments, as my husband first demonstrated in the bridal suite at the Hotel Taft. But with Georgia taking over the lead, we've got ourselves a real shot. The show is going on! What do you say, gang? Are you with me?
Count!
You don't know the love in you.
Jessica Crabshaw, drinks are on me!
No, I'm sorry! Listen, this theater's quarantined. am I wrong? All right, but to the best of my recollection, Jessica Cranshaw never left the stage in the final moments of the show. If that's true, then I'm sorry, but she must have been murdered by one of you. I've never had a case with this many suspects before, and I can't have each of you followed around the clock. It's better just to keep you all under lock and key here until I solve this crime.
You're taking the law into your own hands, Chalfie.
Miss Benson,
that's sort of what I'm paid to do. That's why they gave me my own badge. And it's gone.
Anyway, being sequestered here will help you focus on fixing the show.
Fixing?
Hey, keep your stinking hands off me! Do you hear me?
Who's that?
Sounds like it's my husband, on his best behavior.
I guess he left New York.
Lucky New York.
Well, isn't this just peachy keen? You all waited up for me. Jenny, I'm still wearing my coat.
Sorry, Mr. Bernstein.
Oh, Sydney, it's been a god awful night.
Oh, I hear you, Chris.
And I'm turning in my resignation.
I can't hear you, Chris. Oscar, how you holding up?
Oh, can't complain.
Ha! That's right, you can't.
Welcome back to Boston, Sydney.
Well, hello.
It's me, Sydney, your stepdaughter.
Oh, sorry about that.
It's Bambi.
And the last of the least, Miss B, my junior partner and lesser half.
All right, let's get it over with, Sydney.
What? You expect me to be upset? I leave you in charge of opening night, return to find a murdered leading lady, then the reviews and a bunch of cops who tell me I can't leave this.
I'm afraid you've arrived at just the wrong time for you, Mr. Benson, and just the right time for me.
Excuse me?
Lieutenant Frank Chalfie. Now listen, folks, I'd like you to all go about your various tasks just as if this was not the scene of a crime. All right, Detective McNichol will be waiting downstairs for your pertinent information. I'd like all of you to give me your name, your address, and an 8x10 glossy, and I'll speak with all of you in the morning. Pleasant dreams, everyone.
Lieutenant, I can't be a suspect. I was in Manhattan just when got murdered.
Can you prove that?
Well, as a matter of fact, I can. I happen to be keeping company with a young actress I happen to be, keeping. On some place. If I give you her name, it can ruin her reputation.
Your chivalry is touchingly convenient, Mr. Benson.
I have many influential friends in New York City, Detective.
Well, that's too bad you're in Boston.
And will you be wanting me any further, Lieutenant?
Oh, no, but I do have some questions for your boyfriend.
Oh, I don't have a boyfriend.
Well, actually, Miss Harris, I'd like to take you into my confidence regarding this investigation.
Why is that, Lieutenant?
Because if I don't, there's really no reason for us to keep talking.
Oh, well, then take me into your confidence with confidence, Lieutenant.
Something's very wrong here. I just met an opening night cast who was very eager to close.
Well, I can understand how they might feel. They all gave up wonderful jobs and hit Broadway musicals just to work up here in Boston. I've never performed outside of the city. And Bambi's had to fight her mother at every step just to be in the chorus. But the rest of the cast is underpaid and overworked, though surely not enough to drive anyone to murder.
Well, just keep in mind, I'm within arm's reach day or night.
Oh, you think I'm in some danger?
No, that was a completely unrelated thought.
You live in danger on a daily basis, don't you?
Oh, no, Miss Harris, most of the time it's just paperwork and procedure. Us detectives have no opening night. We make our entrance after the curtain closes on somebody else's life.
Well, that's like a calling, isn't it? Like a doctor or a teacher.
Or an actor.
I suppose you're right. I can't imagine doing anything else with my life. It isn't wrong to be married to one's work, is it?
Well, no. But sometimes it's no good. I love my job. I really do. And if I say so myself, I'm good at it too. I catch the bad guys, well, most of the time. So it's a good life, a perfectly good life, not exactly sublime. When I finish my work and I crawl into bed, I reflect as I turn out the lights that the day that's to come and the week that's ahead. They're all married, of course.
Sometimes we go bowling or have a few beers. So it's a fine life, a perfectly fine life. I give it 2 cheers. 'Cause sometimes I think at the end of the day, when I've read the last Burberry's rights, that the life that I lead is a little bit gray, with its lunch counter mornings and coffee shop nights. Lunch counter mornings and coffee shop nights.
But your acting roles, well, don't they make for a change?
Oh, Miss Harris, each year from May 24th to the 12th of June, when I turn my life over to the Swallow Street Players, that's more than a vacation for me. That's an overdose.